shouldn't be able to use. I'll go through here rather than taking apart all of those. Alright. Lots of computers to try. Whisper sweet gentle nothings into its ear. Say, work for me, darling. Work for me. Okay. We are outside. Look at all that garbage. From aloud and pray and cross my fingers. Wish me luck. Oops, that's not what I meant to do. That is also not what I meant to do. Okay, I'm pressing wrong buttons everywhere. Actually, really enjoy my quiet gaming. It's just nice, you know. Just game very quietly. The volume is down a bit, you know. Very calm, very chill. Well, until things start murdering me, but you know. Ha. personnel must pass through decontamination when entering or exiting the facility. All personnel must display a rank 22 at minimum security badge with updated photo ID. Failure will result in immediate security lockup until the person may be questioned and confirmed. Guests must present a signed letter of approval from General Rawlings and employee point of contact. All guests must display a guest badge with limited access. Guests must be accompanied at all times. Guests found unattended will be held for questioning, and the point of contact will be responsible for their actions. Alright, Epsilon 6 security alert, which is what we've got. In the event of a fault in the code conditioning protocol, resulting in a mass uprising of the robot janitorial staff, any Class 2 supervisor is authorized to declare an Epsilon 6 security alert. If such an alert is initiated, all security and defensive systems will activate. Remote terminal functions will be disabled, and the control center will enter an automated lockdown state. Facility staff are advised to arm themselves and shelter in place. An external review will be conducted by the Military Robotics Oversight Committee. Within 10 business days to determine the appropriate course of action, this alert may be terminated by remote authorization from the MROC or by the facility administrator from the master control terminal to the control center as a failsafe if the control center has been compromised. A limited manual override can be initiated from the elevator access terminal at security room 3. Voice print identification of 3 registered Class 2 supervisor level employees is required to activate the override. All right. This is the decontamination terminal. Easy way to get it working and get rid of all those laser sensors is to just turn this on. Taurus, nope.
Security's too good. No way I'm cracking this.
I don't have high enough hacking for that.
engineer, Thomas Harkin. So far, we're tracking on schedule for the latest RoboBrain milestone. Dr. Asante has assured me that the active time between memory wipes has been greatly increased. Hopefully, that will hold true in our latest live testing. The senior engineers also informed me that their latest assembly line adjustments have been completed early. I can only hope that means due diligence was still paid, and we're not going to be looking at a total system breakdown again. Other than that, I'm still worried about the, test subjects. Right now, we've got more than enough to meet our demand. But it's not like these things grow on trees.
Okay. After dome implantation, the brain on the above subject started exhibiting physical changes. The subject's dura turned some kind of a mottled brown color and started to break down after only 12 hours in the solution. Turns out, the biogel was tainted with sulfuric acid runoff from the dome polishing compound. And a reaction was occurring when they met. Unfortunately, this subject is a total loss. We'll have to just write it off as bad luck and switch polishing compounds immediately. We're continuing to have issues maintaining cohesion between the neural interface and the spinal column nerve endings. The nerves reject the connections faster than we can rebind them. I know we were hoping to keep the spinal columns intact for the RoboBrains, but it's obviously not going to happen. I'd suggest we revert back to the original plan, the good old brain in the jar prototype. It will reduce the amount of life support subsystems significantly, as well as cut production time almost by a third. I'll submit my findings to the brass in Washington tomorrow. We got the first batch of RoboBrains back from testing, and they're a mess. Cracked domes, throwing threads, overloaded fusion piles, fried circuits, the list goes on and on. This particular issue is troubling, though. According to field users, some of the RoboBrains are misinterpreting commands. The onboard brain seems to almost overthink these instructions and decide to rewrite them for efficiency purposes. Most of the time, this results in property damage, or even a few civilian fatalities. I've gone over every square inch of the faulty units, and I can't find a thing wrong with them. One of the RoboBrains rolled off the line with a faulty voice module. When it speaks, it's speaking in reverse. This troubled me, so I had them shut down the line for almost 8 hours while I checked the software for issues, and then gave the audio output assembler a thorough diagnostic. I didn't find any issues, so I gave them the all clear to resume assembly and marked it down as a glitch. I have no idea what would cause such a ridiculous issue, but if you ask me, I think one of the guys upstairs thought it would be funny. Thank you. Okay. Max call and they have me babysit a bunch of generators. I can strip a Mr. Andy or Protectron down to its base parts in under 2 hours, and they stick me here. What a waste of time. After talking to Sharpley during my smoke break, I thought of a way to turn my isolation into an advantage. I've got a buddy in the civilian service who works for a vending company, and he reckons that I can make a few bucks if I stick one of his cigarette machines down here. It would save everyone a trip all the way to the surface if they're out of smokes, and give me an excuse to say hi to any of the ladies that happen to wander in to purchase some. I'll tell you, Sharpley's a goddamn genius. I might even have to comp him a few free packs for his help. I took all the trouble to sneak that machine into my substation, just to have Banks over at Substation B start complaining about the smoke. At first I thought he was just jealous that all of the ladies had been hanging around my new cigarette machine during their smoke breaks. Then he showed all his cards when he told me he's going to lodge a formal complaint with Delano if I don't make him happy. He doesn't care about the smoke. Sneaky little thief just wants a cut of the cigarette sales. I might have to pay him off to keep the brass off my back. Finally got official approval to keep the cigarette machine in my substation. I'm pretty sure the free cartons that found their way onto the general's desk may have had something to do with it. Now Banks can't do a damn thing about it, and he isn't getting a single penny. Looks like this electrical engineer just came out on top for once. Substation A. Politics. All of the politics of work, eh? Looking up. Unit PT-75, currently awaiting orders. Assignment disposal. Status completed. P-875 Protectron, request experiencing voice distortion. Check speakers or hardware. Assigned, none. G-421, Mr. Gutsy. Request no optic readings from center eye stalk. Needs replacement. Assigned, B. McDaniel. P-466 Protectron. Request evaluation needed. Left leg lost in assembly accident. Replace or decommission. Assigned D. Delano. September production orders approved by T. Harkin. 500 feet of copper wire. 160 by 120 steel sheets. 8 high temperature air filters. 2 Romco model E601 terminals. September R&D orders pending approval. 200 autoclave bags. 2 Sharps pens. 50 units of isopropyl alcohol. And then there's the faculty director's holotape. There's also a bag down here.
Open this. check that out.
Can't be done.
Okay, then, Ada. That's okay, because we can find the password for this computer and get in there anyway. For that, we just go over here. And right there. They're offloading another set of subjects to us today. I don't know what these men and women did to deserve being sent here, but since they were transferred from civilian penitentiaries, I can only assume they're the worst society has to offer. I don't think these people have any idea what's about to happen to them. One thing's for sure, these prisoners would have been better off serving their time elsewhere. I'm starting to hear rumors around the block that I don't like. Esteban told me that he overheard two of the eggheads saying that the prisoners are having the brains cut out of their heads or something like that. I know that the brass is running experiments on these inmates and that they were pretty intense, but I didn't know they were literally cutting them open. I'm not sure how I feel about that. After all, I joined the military because I wanted to serve my country and protect my fellow Americans. I guess I'll keep it to myself for now. The rumors floating around the block are getting worse. One of our informants said that the prisoners are talking about rioting. If the things that they're saying are true, that inmates are getting dissected and the parts used for robots. I almost can't say that I blame them. Esteban said we should go right to Gamma 9 status, but I don't want to push the panic button unless I absolutely have to. I've decided to take this all the way to the top and meet with General Rawlings. Criminals are not. These experiments are wrong, and they need to be stopped before it's too late. Roderick got reassigned out of the facility today. I think they have him scrubbing toilets at some backwater listening post in Anchorage now. They put me in charge of the cell block and I initiated Gamma 9 status. After 2 days, the threat of rioting has ended and everything is back to normal. The brass gave me the go-ahead to start sending people to the medical section, and everything is proceeding as planned. If we have any hope of beating the enemy at their own game, we need to get these robots online. Who cares what happens to a few lousy inmates? I told Broderick he needed to fall in line, but he wouldn't listen. Of all people, I would have expected him to understand that the needs of the many outweigh the needs of the few. Here.
your service.
And if you have any questions that I can help with in here, I do keep in mind though that before you ask that I play on PC only. I don't play it on Xbox or anything else. And so therefore all of the add-ons I use, as well as all of the issues that I know how to get around, versions for Xbox and stuff, I don't know. I myself only play PC games, so. And I don't know about you, but I love falling asleep. Scary stories and like scary games and stuff like that. I don't know, it makes me sleepy. his brain survival rate for the procedure is no longer at risk. A 53, 48-year-old female. Convicted for arson. Burned down a courthouse, leaving three dead. Only approach when sedated. Family medical history of dementia. Brain health is likely to decline or skew data. Recommended for termination. A 57, 22-year-old female. Convicted for murder of a waitress. Prone to sudden outbursts of violence. Recommend subject be restrained at all times or sedated. Highly emotional. Currently on a cocktail of antidepressants and anti-anxiety. Dr. Hasselbert is starting psychiatric sessions to further see if she's a good candidate. A 72, 32-year-old male. Convicted of second-degree murder while under the influence of alcohol. Subject displays high intelligence and knowledge of tactics. Slight signs of PTSD. Dr. Hasselbert to evaluate for treatment. A 88, 33-year-old female. Ex-military. Convicted of second-degree manslaughter. Assault resulting in hospitalization and later death of the victim. Subject is highly intelligent and proved to be mentally sound. Approved for candidacy. Sure, now you come running. Like, oh my god, she's gonna leave me. Don't worry, Ada. I'm not gonna leave you. Blood bags. There we go. Decontamination. Once again, thanks to equipment failures, we're getting pretty backed up in this department. The brain extractors were never made to operate at this capacity. I think they've been running around the clock for the last few weeks. We usually end up with a pop blade from slicing through a particularly tough skull, or the hydraulics in the pulling arm seize up when the spinal cord isn't fully severed, and the brain is pulled too early. I hope that Ciroletti doesn't yell at us again. This really settled on the extractor Sunrise. Too bad we can't share with the other departments, but the biogel costs like $1,000 a pint. And I don't think Cirelletti would appreciate us drinking down some of her budget. Today was Elsie's birthday, so we made him a brain-shaped cake. Well, sort of. We actually just took one of the extracted brains and covered it with frosting. Of course, we didn't tell Elsie that. The look on his face when he bit down on the slice we gave him was pretty hilarious. It was a waste of a decent subject brain, but the prank was totally worth it. We really have some good times down here. I sincerely hope that they don't reassign anyone away from the department. We're working well together, and our efficiency rating can't get much higher.
Cirelletti, Chief Scientist. This is the third time I've had to request more security. As thorough as our assembly procedures may be, there's a human factor to be considered. These are criminal and unstable minds. It can't be a scientist's job to ensure each test subject is properly sedated. I was promised military assistance and security, but we need more. I won't allow my crew to be endangered. As fascinating as it may be to integrate the human mind with robotics, sometimes I wish I never signed on to this project.
Subject A-22. Successful. No damage. Original age and gender, 34 male. Transcript. Cirelletti. Hello, can you understand me? What? Who? Who is that? Where are you? I can't see. Oh my god, what have you people done to me? Calm down, calm down. I can't feel my body. I can't feel anything. What's going on? Please, this is horrible. A-22, if you don't calm down, I'll have to turn you off. Turn me off? You mean kill me? For the love of God, tell me what the hell you've done. Terminating A-22. Subject to unstable. I think I'd be pretty unstable. Subject A-57. Possible frontal lobe damage. Original age and gender. 22, female. Cirelletti. standby. Error. Unknown fragment detected. What? This can't be real. My arms, my legs, they're gone. What's wrong with me? Switching off. Ah, there it is. That was quadrant in the temporal lobe. Can we get a tech in here to clear out the long term? And tell them to stop being so sloppy about it. A124. Successful. No damage. 36 male. Recording now. Repeat that again. I said that if you don't put me back in my body, I'm going to kill you. And everyone else in this place. Interesting. You do realize that you're simply a brain attached to a vocal interface. That you don't have the capability to perform those actions. I don't care. I'll find a way. And when I do, you'll be the first to die. Wonderful. Simply wonderful. The lack of your original body doesn't disturb you. No, it doesn't matter. Whatever it takes, I'll end all of you. Switching off. Excellent. As soon as we flush the long and short term, this one will be ready. Recommend sending it along to Rawling's tactical team as soon as it's fitted in a chassis. Of course that's what they want, the total psycho. Why, though, why would you want a psychotic robot that wants to kill you? Like, my goodness. Alright, got lots of goodies here. Right. issues with them. But we know that. Thank you.
Operation capacity exceeded. Now drawing reserve power.
Sparks! I'll deal with you myself. Come, my robots. Destroy her!
The new thought is what I always have trouble with.
Code 00.
I'll see.
Thank you.
imminent.
Not a villain. I just want you to hear me out, face to face.
To what end? So you can crush me as you crushed my allies? Besides, do you truly think I'd leave the safety of my command center?
Don't you want to know the truth?
The destruction you've caused is truth enough!
Good people, listen. Making a grave mistake. You'd want to know the truth.
Very well. I will hear you out, but only for the sake of the Commonwealth. Sparks, with me!
That mask.
You're right. It's time I faced the true enemy of the Commonwealth.
There. Now we both know who we're dealing with.
Hey, I'm not the enemy. I'm the one trying to protect the Commonwealth against your robots.
They have taken innocent lives. My friends. They were simple traitors, all dead at the hands of your robots.
No, that's not true. The robots are programmed to protect. Their subroutines are clean. Observe, evaluate, and react accordingly. The testing was thorough. I ran every scenario, all passed.
They're misinterpreting orders. Your own robo-brain said as much. They're saving people by killing them.
No. I don't believe you. They can't alter their programming. They're programmed to save people, not kill them.
Think about it. There's probably a reason these robots weren't in mass production.
The introduction of a human brain creates too many unknown variables. You can't claim to know them all.
I took all the necessary precautions. Innocent lives should never be taken. And the data. They were always reporting hostiles killed and lives... Oh, saved. No, it's... the logic. Oh, it's there. I can see it now. I was hoping it was the RoboBrains. An issue with their memory wipes. But you're right. Their primary directive was flawed.
The RoboBrains require memory wipes?
Yes. The human brain has a way of rewiring itself. If not properly maintained, it can corrupt.
That sounds like a serious flaw, and a dangerous one at that.
It is, but the process is thorough. They're wiped after each mission. I found it's best not to let them recall what they've been through.
Now you know the truth. Your robots are dangerous. They had to be stopped.
The hero unknowingly became the villain. I wanted to help the Commonwealth. And robots are all I know. I found this place and figured I could finally do my part. I accept full responsibility. I can't take back what I've done, or even atone for it. But this doesn't have to end in violence.
Tell me, why the mask? What's with the Mechanist?
I'm not good with people. The Mechanist gave me a way to put myself out there without really being out there at all. But you're kind of keeping me in suspense here. I can turn this around. I just need a chance.
I'm not here to kill you. Only to get you and your robots to stand down.
Done. Consider it done. And you won't regret this. I promise. None of the Commonwealth will. Here, take this. It's the password to the mainframe. You can use it to shut down the security protocols. I'd rather this place be in your hands now.
Time to take control of the facility. Let's hope this entry sticks. I finally got one of the terminals up and running. Now to hope I have the same luck with the rest of this facility. This place is incredible. An entire wing devoted to RoboBrain research and development. I've never seen any robots quite like these. Except in a few of the comics I've read. And the brains. They're still preserved after all this time. I can't wait to start delving into the schematics to assemble one myself. The potential for the RoboBrains seems limitless. I've managed to update a few of them to handle some of the menial tasks around. facility fully functional for my own purposes faster than I thought. I've a new mission, the safety of the Commonwealth. I think I can program the robots here to safely police the surrounding area, possibly up to a 15-mile radius. I was laying in bed, staring at the posters I found, and it occurred to me, I could really make a difference here. I'm gonna start constructing the mechanist suit in the drawing I found. The mechanist suit turned out even better than I'd hoped. Sparks gave a very approving beep. I even added a voice augmentation to it. It's strange how it makes me feel so confident when I put it on. It's like being a different person. And that's exactly why and sometimes use a VTuber model is because it's like being someone else, you know. It's like it becoming a character, becoming somebody else, not yourself anymore. Spotlight schematic. Today marks the dawning of a new age for the Commonwealth. No longer will the innocent settlers need to fear the cruel and savage nature of the raiders and gunners. My robots will ensure the safety of all the people by targeting and eliminating all threats. The day is near where we can truly focus on rebuilding the Commonwealth without the threat of surrounding dangers. The RoboBrains report a significant decrease in my robot allies. For the good of the Commonwealth, I've increased production. I won't allow my efforts to be destroyed by such criminal scum. Somewhere in the Commonwealth, a true villain has risen. The loss of my robots is no longer acceptable. I must now focus on defense improvements to my sanctum. I cannot run the risk of this new scourge gaining control of my resources. That was me, the scourge. First test runs on the robot allies inside a controlled environment. Went fairly well when it came to detecting and scanning other robots in the area and determining if they were hostile or not. Following tests will be a bit trickier. I'm not even sure how to manage a live test right now. The whole idea kind of freaks me out. I've never intentionally killed anyone. And these bots are sort of built to do that. Initial testing was brutal, but it's improving. The allies could detect and analyze the threat of a weapon pretty well. But once you have one in the hand of an innocent, they immediately designate them as hostile. I need some better detection methods. It's possible they'll miss some hostiles judging by appearance, but better safe than sorry. I think I got it. Testing group was able to pick out the dummies I created based on clothing and hostile actions. I think I spent a good week on creating different scenarios. Now I just need a live testing spot. I really don't even want to think about it. I did it. Live testing. I had a recon bot go out and find a raider camp based on specs These groups tend to have a consistent look to them. The Allies went in, eliminated the threat, and even noted in the data that two lives were saved in the process. While I'm really excited about the two lives saved, I'm not sure if I'll sleep tonight. Raiders may have murdered a lot of people in my old settlement, but for me to be responsible for taking lives... That is all of the files there.
New primary use in the Commonwealth. Your return is a relief. I trust the outcome was what you wanted.
Would you be disappointed to hear that I let her live?
I do have conflicting outlooks if that is the case. But I trust your judgment. If she lives, she does so with the guilt of what she's done.
I got her to see the truth. She's standing down.
So the Mechanist really was misguided. Did she reveal her motives and reasoning?
She was fooled by her own logic. She really thought she was saving people.
A biological wild card. The unknowns are vast. She had to know the risk she was taking by creating them. Many good people endured suffering and death because of the Mechanist. It's a shame a mind as brilliant as hers allowed such atrocities to be committed.
She's good at heart. She made a mistake. A big one. She'll live with that guilt.
I believe I have a certain understanding when it comes to guilt. While it's not the justice I had hoped for, it will suffice. Still, I now know that the death of my friends has brought about a safer Commonwealth. Had the Mechanist's robots remained unchecked, I'm certain that damage would have been extensive, halting, if not reversing, any progress that has been made here. With this knowledge, I am finally registering feelings of satisfaction and accomplishment. And I have you to thank for it.
Mechanist.
Hey, just one more thing, if you have a minute.
Sure, go ahead.
Oh, good. Isabel. That's my name. Isabel Cruz. I just wanted to say I'm really happy, thankful that you've let me stick around here. And in order to show you that I'm done with the past, I want you to have this. As a sort of promise, I guess. It's the Mechanist suit I made.
You really don't want it anymore?
No. It's part of a past I don't want to dwell on. It's time I move on. There's one more thing. A much bigger thing. There are still robots out there. Lots of them. My communications are down, and I can't call them back. But I can tell you where they are, if you're interested.
Sure.
Great. Okay. Tracking something. Got it. It looks like only one signal this time. Still, no point in taking any chances, right?
The rogue robot quests.
your service. Glad to be of service.